it's also good to know that people who aren't able to be with us here physically will be hearing the Mass as a recording later on. So we think of that as well. And we all pray for each other on this feast of Saint Jerome. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us turn to our Lord who loves us so much and ask him to forgive our sins and help us to be better. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you give us yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who gave the priest Saint Jerome a living and tender love for sacred scripture, grant that your people may be ever more fruitfully nourished by your word and find in it the fount of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke to his friends. Indeed, I know it is as you say. How can man be in the right against God? If any were so rash as to challenge him for reasons, one in a thousand would be more than they could answer. His heart is wise, and his strength is great. Who then can successfully defy him? He moves the mountains, though they do not know it. He throws them down when he is angry. He shakes the earth and moves it from its place, making all its pillars tremble. The sun at his command forbears to rise, and on the stars he sets a seal. He and no other stretched out the skies and trampled the sea's tall waves. The Bear, Orion too, are of his making, the Pleiades and the mansions of the sun. His works are great, beyond all reckoning, his marvels past all counting. Were he to pass me, I should not see him, nor detect his stealthy movement. Were he to snatch a prize, who could prevent him, or dare to say, "What are you doing?" How dare I plead my cause then, or choose arguments against him? Suppose I am in the right, what use is my defense? For he whom I must sue as judge as well. If he deigned to answer my citation, could I be sure that he would listen to my voice? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
I call to you, Lord, all the day long. To you I stretch out my hand. Will you work your wonders for the dead? Will the shade stand and praise you?
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
Will your love be told in the grave, or your faithfulness among the dead? Will your wonders be known in the dark, or your justice in the land of the living?
Let my prayer come into your presence, O Lord.
As for me, Lord, I call to you for help. In the morning my prayer comes before you. Lord, Why do you reject me? Why do you hide your face?
Let my prayer
into
your presence, O Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia. Your word is a lamp for my steps and a light for my path. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus and his disciples travelled along, they met a man on the road who said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. Jesus answered, Foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Another to whom he said, Follow me, replied, Let me go and bury my father first. But he answered, Leave the dead to bury the dead. Your duty is to go and spread the news of the kingdom of God. Another said, I will follow you, sir, but first let me go and say goodbye to my people at home. Jesus said to him, Once the hand is laid on the plough, no one who looks back is fit for the kingdom of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. St. Jerome lived in the 4th century, and he was a priest, and he was secretary to Pope St. Damasus, who did a great deal about the cult of the martyrs, honouring and venerating the martyrs who had witnessed to Christ. But at a time when the church itself enjoyed a certain amount of freedom, Jerome himself felt that he needed solitude, and so after he discharged his responsibilities to the Pope, he went to live as a hermit in a cave in Bethlehem. But while he was a hermit, he embarked on a translation of the Bible, and the reason for that was that he believed as a scripture scholar, and indeed as a Christian, that ignorance of the scriptures was ignorance of Christ, or to put it a little less hard, not to know the scriptures is not to know Christ. So he was very keen indeed that ordinary Catholics developed a great love and understanding of the scriptures so that they might feel closer to Christ. And so he translated the Bible, which at that time was in Greek and Hebrew, into Latin, which was the language of the people in the Western Roman Empire. And his translation is called the Vulgate, which means the translation of the crowd, of the people. And this was the translation of the Bible that was used in the church's liturgy. And of course, in the 4th century, many people weren't able to read or write, but at least they could hear the scriptures proclaimed in their own language, in a language that they could understand. And it was such a wonderful translation of the Bible that it's in fact the only translation of the Bible from the original languages that is regarded by the Church as being inspired. Every other translation is just a version of the original inspired word of God. At the Second Vatican Council, the Council Fathers decided that the faithful should be exposed to a rich affair of Holy Scripture, and that's why we have the lectionary as we have it now, where the readings on a daily basis come from a far wider selection of biblical books than ever before in recent church history. And it's no accident that people who are writing commentaries on the books of the Bible to help us understand them more took St. Jerome as their patron, And so one of the most prominent commentaries on the Bible is called the Jerome Biblical Commentary, in honour of St. Jerome, who just wanted us to be more familiar with the scriptures. Well, we're in the happy position that not only do we hear the scriptures proclaimed in church, which is the privileged way of the scriptures being presented to us, but we have the ability to read them and reflect on them ourselves, and there are all sorts of aids to help us do that. So we thank St. Jerome for the gifts he gave to the church of scholarship and love of the scriptures and love of the people and, of course, holiness. And we pray that he may continue to inspire scholars today, but also us as the faithful to an ever greater deepening of our understanding of the Word of God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, that having meditated on your word, following the example of St. Jerome, we may more eagerly draw near to offer your majesty the sacrifice of salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Jerome you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim, Holy,
Holy, Holy, Holy, Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, that they will pour your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Saviour's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always,
and with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The blood of Christ.
Amen.
Lord God, your words were found and I consumed them. Your word became the joy and happiness of my heart. Let us pray. May these holy gifts we have received, O Lord, as we rejoice in celebrating St. Jerome, stir up the hearts of your faithful, so that, attentive to sacred teachings, they may understand the path they are to follow, and by following it, obtain life everlasting, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I hope you all have a very good day, and let us now ask for God's blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.